Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel, Unique Bio Classes, based on NCERT syllabus for PU, first and second year. If you like my channel, please subscribe, like and share and hit with the bell icon so that you can get notifications as soon as videos are getting uploaded. Okay guys, I would like to request you all, please share these videos with the first year students who have just passed and entered into a second year. So please share with those so that it can help those students also. Fine. In my previous class, I have discussed about sickle cell anemia. Now today we shall discuss about phenylketonuria. Phenylketonuria in your NCERT textbook, you will get on page number 90. Okay. Here you will get phenylketonuria. What is this phenylketonuria? Phenylketonuria, it is an inborn error of metabolism, which means this is related to metabolic reactions. What is metabolism? First you have straight. Okay, you have said it as the sum total of all chemical reactions occurring in our body. Is it all chemical reactions which occur in a cell or in an body, we call it as metabolism. So this is an inborn error. It is by birth error of metabolism. Okay, so about this one, I have prepared a note of it. We shall see here. Okay, here it is. Phenylketonuria, which is in short, it has been mentioned as PKU. Okay, the first point, it is an inborn error of metabolism, as just now I have said what it is. It is an autosome recessive trait. Autosome, these are the chromosomes other than the sex chromosomes, right? Which means this disease is not related to sex, which means it is coming only under males or it is coming only under females. No, it's not like that. It can be either male or a female. Anyone can get this disease. Okay, it is an autosome recessive, it is not dominant, it is in recessive condition. Okay, recessive character or recessive disease. Phenylketonuria affected individual, what does they do? They lack an enzyme, they does not produce one enzyme. Okay, they won't produce one enzyme. Which enzyme it is? This one is phenylalanine hydroxylase. Okay. Phenylalanine hydroxylase is the enzyme which is not produced in those patients who are phenylketonuria due to abnormal recessive gene. Why this is not produced? This enzyme is necessary. Why this gene? Why this enzyme is not produced? Because they does not have. They have one gene which is quite abnormal and it is in a recessive condition. The normal gene which will produce phenylalanine hydroxylate, that gene is abnormal in these patients, so that they are not able to produce this enzyme. As you know, the function of enzyme is to convert substrate into a product, right? Hope you remember. Again, this one was there in your first year. Okay, one enzyme, it will convert one substrate into a product. When this enzyme is not produced, its substrate is not getting converted into product. Substrate will remain as it is. Okay, so we shall see what are the substrate and this is helpful for to convert which kind of amino acids. This enzyme means what? Which enzyme? This enzyme means phenylalanine hydroxylase. This enzyme converts the amino acid. Which amino acid? Phenylalanine into tyrosine. Okay, this phenylalanine hydroxylase converts amino acid phenylalanine into tyrosine. What is this phenylalanine and tyrosine? Both are the amino acids. This amino acid should be converted to another kind of amino acid because it is a chain of metabolic reaction. In this metabolic reaction, when this one is converted to this, then this will convert to some other and its byproducts will be water and the carbon dioxide. So those are helpful. It should be converted. But here what happened is, this phenylalanine is not getting converted into tyrosine. So why? Because this enzyme is not present. It lacks this enzyme. Okay. Now phenylalanine, its short form is PHE. Okay. PHE is used for the short form of this enzyme, this amino acid. And this amino acids can be used by three letter short form, or it also it has been given by alphabets also. About this, I have said it before also. Anyhow, this is phenylalanine, which should be converted to tyrosine with the help of this enzyme phenylalanine hydroxylase. Because this enzyme is not produced, now phenylalanine is not getting converted to tyrosine. So what happens to phenylalanine? Phenylalanine, it will start to get accumulate, okay, because it is not getting converted into another form. So it will start gets accumulated and it is converted into phenylpyruvic acid. rather than getting converted to tyrosine. Now this phenylalanine, it will start to accumulate and it will be converted into phenylpyruvic acid and also some other derivatives. Okay, not only this, it is also getting converted into some other derivatives also, which results in hyperphenylalaninemia. Okay, hyper means more. Okay, high level. Hypo means low. Hyper means high, which means hyperphenylalaninemia, which means what? Phenylalanine is present in a large amount. It is present in a high quantity. Where? In that patient's body. Why it is present in a large amount? Because it is not converted into, it's a product. Is it? This is a substrate, this is a product. Because it is not getting converted, this one will start to accumulate and it will be converted into some other derivatives or phenylpyruvic acid, and its quantity will be increased in our body, because of which it results in phenylalaninemia. Okay. Not only this, it accumulates in brain. As we said, it will get accumulated. Where it will get accumulated? It will get accumulated in brain, resulting in, okay, which results in mental retardation, which means mentally unstable. Okay, mentally they are unable to take any decisions, right? So it accumulates in the brain, which is getting accumulated in brain, phenylalanine. It is accumulated in the brain, which results in mental retardation, and also it is excreted through urine. Same phenylalanine can be excreted directly through urine. Because of its, why it is excreted through urine? Because of its poor absorption by kidney. Because kidney could not absorb this phenylalanine directly. So because when it could not absorb, what does it do? It will release that phenylalanine through urine. Okay. So this is some information related to phenylketonuria. Very short and easy. And related to this phenylketonuria, we have discussed in some other video also. If possible, I'll try to share that link where I have discussed about, only I have said about phenylketonuria, and what it is actually, I have said that I will discuss in my another video. So this is that video, and related to that video, if possible, I will share a link in the description box. Okay, so if you have any doubts, any queries, please comment it in the comment box. And this phenylketonuria, it can be asked for 1 mark, 2 mark, 3 marks. Okay, so be careful. They can ask, name the enzyme which is lacked in phenylketonuria. Okay, so whatever, any information they can ask, so be prepared. Very easiest it is. Hope you like it. If you like my channel, please subscribe, like and share. Okay, we shall meet in my next video with the chromosomal disorders. Mendelian disorders are also there, like thalassemia. I shall discuss about that in my next video. Okay, so stay safe, stay healthy.